have very tough competitions. However, I'm hoping to get my best shots in the final round, and I'm looking forward to seeing you guys, and I'll try my best and be the firework that I always dream of. I'll let the color blush. Thank you very much.
So right now, please give a warm welcome to our contestant, Love Me Dry. So this topic for today is the destruction of the world's forest is justified by human needs for land and food. Please enjoy the speech.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Before I commence my speech, I would like to, you know, pay my respect to Obiante Tonight, General Director of NTC Group, Mr. Nguyen, CEO of NTC Group, all management team, prestigious judges, and all the honorable audiences spending a valuable time. Well, one in Melbourne this morning, as Melbourne as everybody here. But today, I am very delighted to be able to stand here and present you guys a topic that the entire world have been waiting for. But ladies and gentlemen, today's topic is actually the destruction of the world forest is justified by human needs for food and land. Ladies and gentlemen, before we get any further into the topic, let me define several key terms that do exist in the topic. So first of all is destruction. Destruction is a process or the action of causing damage to something. Second is justify, it means to sacrifice or, you know, have done for something. So ladies and gentlemen, the whole topic today simply debating about if human is the one to blame for, you know, the forest destruction just because they're owning for land and food. Ladies and gentlemen, today I am proud to stand here and emphasize my standard. I strongly disagree with the topic by raising up two significant and very indispensable reasons in order to persuade everybody to stay at the same spot. So first of all, it's just because people survive by food supply from farms. Ladies and gentlemen, before I start it, I want to ask you, do you eat, you know, apple, vegetable, fruit, a pot, a meat, or any type of food from forest or from Amazon forest? But that sounds ridiculous, definitely. So, you know, this is as a result, we can see that not people eat all the food from forest. So, we, I mean, human is not the one to blame for, you know, destruction of forest just because they eat everything from the forest, but it's actually not, because all the food they eat was coming from a farm, food industry, I mean food industrials or industrial. So that is a, you know, a solution. So ladies and gentlemen, to take you a better illustration, I want you guys to take a look to this example. That's all the chicken, the pork, the beef, you know, all the meat that's produced and put it into a burger that, you know, sell in worldwide famous fast food chamber like McDonald's or Burger King. Did they get all those beef from the forest? Well, no, that's a gigantic number of beef. And that is the thing. So we can see that all the food that we eat does actually not come from the forest. And that as a result, we're not destroying the forest by eating anything from it. Ladies and gentlemen, that goes to the very last point that I'm going to present today. It's about skyscraper can help to reduce the need for land expansion. Ladies and gentlemen, you know that the increasing amount of population in the world was increasing rapidly, right? So that is the thing. So we need more space. We demand more living space. And that's what we're really concerned about, because there are more than 7 billion people in the world. And where are we going to live? So skyline or high skyscrapers or high-rise buildings can actually solve this, you know, this problematic thing that people are wondering about. So just because that, because the investment of technology, architecture, and construction, we are able to build a gigantic construction building in order to gather people in just one small place, but otherwise we, you know, risk it up hard. So ladies and gentlemen, let's take a look to a, you know, real illustration in Singapore or New York. I think that Singapore should be a very perfect example for all of you. So Singapore is a very tiny country in Asia, right? But how are people going to fit in this? It is really small. So that the solution is a, you know, high-rise apartment, high building, gigantic you know, skyscraper that constructed and located in Singapore can actually solve this problem. That people can fit together in just one business, and I mean in just one, you know, building, and we can actually live together and not, you know, wasting a lot of space and destroy the nature and the forest. So ladies and gentlemen, together we can draw a line really strongly. You know, I am both mentally and physically disagreeing with the topic by raising up two significant and indispensable reasons that I already mentioned. So first of all, it's actually equal to my food, by the food supply from Taiwan. Second, it's actually skyline reduce the need for land expansion. So before I leave the stage right here, I want everybody to remember the phrase. Only the last tree have cut, the last fish are eaten. That the day that we realize that the food that we regrade our nature. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for your speech. And right now, I would love to invite the judges to ask the question. Thank you.
Hello. You mentioned that people cut down forests for food. We were discussing one reason. What are some of the other reasons that humans cut down forests?
Okay, thank you very much. The reasons that people cutting down the tree just because of humanness, their ambitions of money. This is a thing that nobody dares to talk about, right? Because it's involved with corruption and other terrible things that people don't dare to talk about. So the reason that people was destroying the forest, trying to cut down the tree, is because money, you know, it's all about the money. So that's the thing. So all in all, I can say that the other reason that people cutting down the trees from the forest or, you know, protective area, just because they want, you know, they need money and, you know, for their own profit and their own benefit. Thank you very much.
Okay, good morning, Peter.
Good morning.
Okay, so according to the World Environment Report, Brazil alone ranked number four in emission of greenhouse or deforestation in terms of their agricultural activity. So imagine by 2025, according to the United Nations report, the population of people will increase by 8 billion. So according to your idea, what are the possible ways that you can do to support the demand of food or land without the destroying the forest? Thank you.
Thank you very much for your truly amazing question. Well, you know that the population, the world population is increasing rapidly, right? So, what is the solution in order to supply the whole demand for all the humanness without destroying the environment? I think the only time will tell. And the thing is, the development of technology, agriculture advancement could also help in order to produce even more by, you know, involving with some, you know, chemical substance. And I think that it, you know, it sounds terrible, but everything we eat right now is involved with chemical substance like that. But by the time that, you know, we're going to talk about the advancement of technologies and agriculture's knowledge will actually, you know, improve and people will be able to show this problem by those advancements. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much for your speech.